Let us consider LDA system with impulse response h of n, and the input is x of n. The concerned output we are going to get is linear convolution of and h of n. It's a linear convolution. Suppose my input is delta of n, it's an impulse, right? Then the concerned response I am going to get is known as impulse response. Then the output will be delta of n convolution with h of n, which is nothing but h of n. Impulse response, because the input is impulse, and the output we are going to get is the impulse response h of n. Suppose if I get ideal delay system v of n equals to x of n minus n d, it means x of n is the input and this is my h of n. This is the output I am going to get here, v of n minus n d. Suppose if my input is delta of n, then what is the concerned output I am going to get? Yeah, what is the output? X of n, x replaced with delta, right? In this case, you can have something like that. There is no issue with this. When this is the input, this is the output we are going to get. We can call it as impulse response, which is nothing but h of n in this case. H of n equals delta of n minus n d. Let us consider moving average system. Moving average system means v of n equals 1 by m1 plus m2 plus 1, sigma k equals minus m1 to m2, x of n minus k. And this is a moving average system impulse response which happens. Then the concerned output I'm going to get is as follows. V of n equals to 1 by m1 plus m2 plus 1 sigma k equals to minus m1 to m2 x of n minus k. This is a moving average system. Now, what will be the output for this impulse input? And what is the output? The input is delta of n. The output we are going to get should be same as impulse response, right? That should be same as impulse response. And what will happen? In place of x, I have delta of n in this case. You can simply replace this with delta. It will be 1 by m1 plus m2 plus 1 sigma k equals to minus m1 to m2 delta of n minus k. This is the impulse response of this moving average system. Impulse response of moving average system. If you want, you can cross check. When the input is x of n, output is nothing but x of n convolution with h of n. Yeah, what is the convolution of x of n with delta of n minus k? You can speak out. Can someone answer me this question? What is this convolution? What is the response?
X of n minus k.
Yes, this is x of n minus k. If you want, you can cross check this one. Do convolution of this one with x of n, then we are going to get this as our output. So we can call it as impulse response for this moving average system, right? It's an impulse response for this moving average system. Accumulator system. Suppose input is x of n. This is impulse response of accumulator system. Yeah, can someone answer what will be this one? K equals to minus infinity to n, the summation up to n, right? X of k. This is an accumulator system. x of k plus x of k minus 1 plus x of k minus 2 and so on up to x of minus infinity. A sum up to n, right? Sum up to n. X of n plus x of n minus 1 minus 2 plus and so on up to x of minus infinity. That is nothing but accumulator system. Suppose the input is delta of n. Then according to your guess, what should be this one? In this scenario, this is nothing but impulse response. When the input is impulse, then what should be this? Yeah, can you speak out once? When the input is x of n, the output we are going to get like this. When the input is delta of n, then what should be this output?
Delta of k.
This can be also written as this one. K equal to 0 to infinity. Yeah, what is that? We have seen this, right? We have seen this already. Which is nothing but initial sequence. U of n, initial sequence. It means impulse response for accumulator system is initial sequence. H of n equals to U of n for accumulator system. And what is the impulse response for forward difference system? Yeah, what is the impulse response for forward difference system? This is the forward difference system. What is the impulse response for this? Yeah, I can speak out. When input is x of n, this is the output we are getting for this system. And what is the output when the input x of n equals to delta of n? Yeah, what is the output? Yeah, can you speak out once?
Delta of n plus 1 minus delta.
Yes. That will be delta of n plus 1 minus delta of n, right? When x of n equals delta of n. This is known as impulse response when the input is delta of n. And when coming to backward difference system, when coming to backward difference system, we have n equals to x of n minus x of n minus 1. From this, when the input is delta of n minus delta of n minus 1. You can see that this is non-causal system, right? This is a function of feature. We have any function of x of n plus 1, right? This function of feature, feature sample. This is non-causal system. Causal means practically realizable. It's a causal system. It's a function of present and past, but not function of future. It's a causal system. Okay, can someone how to convert non-causal system into a causal system? Yes, what is the output when this LTI system with this impulse response? Yeah, you can answer. What is the output we are going to get? Y of n equals to. Yeah, what is Y of n? Convolution of the two things. What is that? X of n plus 1 minus X of n, right? This output I am going to get. Suppose I want to make it as a causal system, I can do one thing. I'll try to apply delay. In this case, I'll try to apply delay by one sample. That's more than enough. Then what is the output I'm going to get? Yeah, you should speak out. What is the output? this output. V naught of n equals to, let me call it as V naught of n. What is this? This is the input to this system. Then what is the output? Yeah, what is the output? See, delayed by one sample, right? I'll try to replace. See, y of input for this system, output will be y of n minus 1, right? Delayed by one sample. Delayed by one sample, y of n minus 1 is the output. This is our LTI system. It is nothing but replace n with n minus 1. Gets cancelled out. Then I am going to get x of n. Replace n with n minus 1. Then I am going to get x of n minus 1. Equivalent, right? Okay, is there any issue with this one? I have some input x of n with me and I have some impulse response of the system, some LTI system, and the output I am going to get is x of n convolution with h of n. What I am doing is I am trying to apply this one to some delay system, for example delta of n minus 1 delayed by one sample. After delayed by one sample, I am going to get my output as y of n minus 1. Is there any problem with delay here? Will you miss any information with the delay? Are you missing any information? See, output is delayed by one sample. It doesn't mean that this output totally deviating from this output. Just delayed by one sample, right? For example, if I try to broadcast a song using FM, there will be some delay, right, from transmitter to receiver. Delay doesn't mean that distortion. You will try to listen to that information with some delay. Right? Doesn't mean that you are losing that information. That's why I can go with delay for some operations, at least for some applications. This delay is tolerable. I can simply go for delay by one sample. In this case, this system is non-causal. Non-causal means practically this is not realizable because this is function of future, right? For that, what I am doing is I am trying to apply delay at the end. Indirectly, I want to delay this output y of n by one sample. Delay by one sample doesn't mean that we are losing information. Now I'll try to apply some trick. The trick I am going to apply is I'll try to interchange these two blocks. Is there any problem for you if I interchange? Is it okay or any problem? See, my plan is instead of having these two blocks like this, I want to interchange these two blocks. Let me call it as H1 of n, H2 of n. I want to do with H2 of n followed by H1 of n. Both are LTI systems. Is it true or false? I am going to get once again Y0 of n. Is it true? Yeah, can you speak out once? Is it true or false? Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, can you speak once? Okay, true, right? Yeah, that's fine. Due to commutative property, I can interchange them, right? Due to commutative property, this operation. There's no issue with this, right? Now, what's my plan of action is, yeah, even if you want, you can cross-check, right? The overall system impulse response for this one is delta of n minus delta of n minus 1. The convolution of this and this. Similarly, if we do convolution of this one with this one, we are going to get with this only. Same y naught of n I am going to get. Let's delayed version of y of n. Delayed version of y of n, right? It's tolerable for you, right? Some delay is acceptable. There's no issue with this one. This is my plan of action. If I want to convert a non-causal system into a causal system, I can try this method, right? First, I'll try to apply delay for this input. Then I'm going to get x of n minus 1, right? X of n delayed by one sample. Then I'm going to get x of n minus 1. After that, I can apply this system, right? This non-causal system I can apply at this point. Now, if you try to apply this system to this, then what output I am going to get? Delta of n plus 1, right? Replace n with n plus 1. Then I am going to get n plus 1 minus 1. 1 gets cancelled out. Minus delta of n conversion with h of n minus 1 means minus of x of n minus 1. Now, with reference to this input, this output is causal, right? Because present is n. It's not function of future. In this way, I can do something. First, I'll try to apply some delay to my input. After that, I'll try to pass through this specific system, non-causal system. Then I function, right? I can realize this system without any doubt. Even though this is non-causal, I am able to implement that one with the help of some extra delay. I'll try to apply delay for my input followed by non-causal system. Effectively, this is a causal system. Effectively, this is a causal system, right? There is no issue with this. Y of n. Y of n minus 1 is my output. There is no issue with this, right? Okay, now I'll try to ask a question. Suppose I want to implement this system. This is my H of n. And LTI system, and my required output is 2x of n plus 1 plus 3x of n plus 2 plus 4x of n plus 7 plus 5x of n plus 6x of n minus 1. Is it possible to implement this system? First of all, is it causal system or non-causal system? Okay, is it causal or non-causal? Non-causal system, right? Yes, someone answered this is non-causal system because this is function of feature samples. This output is function of feature samples, right? These are features. Feature sample. This is present, this is past. This is function of future, right? That's why this is non-causal system. I want to implement this system. How to implement this system? Yeah, how to implement this system? Can you speak out? How to make this like causal? How much delay I need to apply? How much delay I need to apply? So that I can make the system like causal. N minus, is it 1 or 2 or 7? Which one is true?
7.
7, right? I can apply delay by 7 samples. Then I can make it like a causal system. For example, you can cross check. Replace n with n minus 7 everywhere. This will become like n minus 6, and this will become like n minus, replace n with n minus 7, and this will become like n, right? N minus 7 plus 7, and this will become like n minus 7, this will become like n minus 8. You can see this output I am going to get is, if I replace with n minus 7, the output I am going to get is, it is just a function of present and past. All of them are past, 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 past. It's not a function of future. It means I can simply go for this, right? Delay this input by 7 samples. I can delay this input by 7 samples so that I am going to get implementable system finally. I can implement this system without any doubt, right? Even though h of n corresponds to this one. Yeah, what is h of n here? Can someone answer? What is h of n here? H of n equal to? Into delta of n plus 1 plus 3 into delta of n plus 2 plus 4 into delta of n plus 7 plus 5 into delta of n plus 6 into delta of n minus 1. Like this you can write. This is my h of n. This is a function of future samples also. It means this is non-causal system. But I am able to implement this system with the help of some delay system. I am going for delay by 7 samples. I am able to make non-causal system like a causal system, implementable system, non-implementable system like a implementable system with the help of delay circuit. Okay, FIR system. A system with a finite duration impulse response is called as FIR system. That length of that impulse response should be finite. Then you can call it as FIR system. For example, ideal delay system, moving system, forward different system, backward different system. These are FIR systems. Can you just tell me length of ideal delay system? What is length of ideal delay system? Where nd is integer? What is length of h of n? This is ideal delay system. See, just one, right? You have only one non-zero sample. Everyone else are zeros, this side and that side. At nd you have one and all others are zeros. Length of this one is only one sample. And when coming to moving average system, h of n will be sigma k equals to minus m1 to m2 delta of n minus k, this whole thing multiplied with that averaging, right? M1 plus m2 plus 1. This is h of n for my moving average system. Let me consider m1 comma m2 less than infinity. When they are finite, what is the length of this one? What is the length of h of n? You can have a look into average means divide by length only, right? Length of this one is nothing but m1 plus m2 plus 1. When m1 and m2 both are finite, this is also finite, m1 plus m2 plus 1. Then you can say this is also FIR system, finite impulse response system. The length of that should be finite. This is also FIR system. Can someone answer what is the length of forward different system? Yeah, can you speak out once? What is the length of this? How much length? Otherwise, this is zero. This is delta of n. This is delta of n plus 1. What is the length? Length of this sequence?
2.
2, right? This is 2. This is also a FIR system. And backward system also a FIR system. Because length of this one also 2. This is finite, right? Less than infinity. Here also length equal to 2. Because this is delta of n. This is delta of n minus 1 delta of n minus 1. All others are zeros. Length of this one also 2. This is also an FIR system, finite impulse response system. In general, FIR systems will be always stable, as long as each of the impulse response values is finite in magnitude. If each of these impulse sample height, if that is finite, by default, FIR system is finite. By default, FIR system will be stable. When all samples of H of n are finite, then FIR system is stable. See, the stability condition is this, right? Sigma k equals minus infinity plus infinity, absolutely summable. Mod H of k should be less than infinity. Stable system, right? Stable LTA system. If you are having finite length, FIR means finite length, right? You are having finite length and each of the sample is finite, then the sum also finite, right? The sum also finite. You won't go from minus infinity plus infinity. You go from some finite index to some other finite index. Then the sum will be finite. All FIR systems are stable. By default, assume that each of the samples are of a finite amplitude. A system with infinite duration impulse response is called as IR system. When the length of that impulse response is infinite, then you can call it as infinite impulse response system. Length of accumulator system. Impulse response of the accumulator system we have seen is U of n, right? Equal to 1. For all n greater than or equal to 0. 1, 2, 3, and so on. 4, 5, and so on. It's always 1, right? For all n greater than or equal to 0. And what is the length of this one? Yeah, can someone answer what is the length? Upper. What is the upper index for this?
Infinite.
Infinite, right? For n greater than or equal to 0. Otherwise, that is 0. Infinite minus 0 is infinite, right? This is infinite impulse response system, accumulator system. Is it stable or unstable? This particular system, is it stable or unstable? Stable means that should be absolutely summable. Sigma minus infinity plus infinity mod H of k. This can be written like k equal to 0 to infinity, 1, right? You are adding 1 infinite times. We are getting infinite, right? This is not less than infinity. This is equal to infinity. This is unstable system. Unstable system, and that is IR system also. Infinite impulse response system. See, all IR systems need not be unstable. For example, I'll try to let me consider impulse response as follows. Whole power n u of n. Okay, is it FIR system or IR system? instance one. 0.24 power n u of n. This is equal to 0 for all n less than 0. Minus 1, minus 2, minus 3 and so on. This is 0. And what is this for n equal to 0? Yeah, what is this for n equal to 0?
1, sir.
Can you speak?
1, sir.
1, right? Yeah. That's fine. For n equal to 0, this is 1. For n equal to 1, this is 0.2. For n equal to 2, this is 0.2 whole square. And so on. This is decreasing. Right then. The length of this one, this will go indefinitely. For n equal to infinity also, this will go, right? It keeps on going. Infinite minus 1. Infinite minus 0, right? This is lower limit. Infinite. This is an IAR system. But this is stable. If you want, you can cross-check. Sigma k equals to minus infinity to plus infinity. Mod equals to sigma k equal to 0 to infinity. Because for k less than 0, this is always 0, right? H of k. 0.2 whole power k. Yeah. Can someone tell me the closed form expression for this? What is this? 1 plus r plus r square r cube plus and so on. When yeah, what is this? See, this is geometric series, right? What is this?
1 by 1 minus r.
Yeah, 1 by 1 minus r. You can have the same thing here. 1 by 1 minus 0.2. It's nothing but 1 by 0.8, which is less than infinite, right? It's a stable system. Because you got this is absolutely summable. It's a stable system. Even though IAR, that is stable. It means some IAR systems can be stable. Some IR systems can be unstable, right? But when coming to FIR systems, they are always stable, FIR systems. And non-causal FIR system into causal FIR system. With the help of some finite delay element, right? With the help of, by delaying your input, you can try to make non-causal FIR system like a causal FIR system. As you have seen that past example, that's also corresponds to causal system, right? The moving average system and all those things corresponds to causal systems, non-causal systems and FIR systems. We are able to convert into causal, right? In that example, delayed by 7 samples. Some example is there, right? That's FIR system. We are able to make it like causal. Okay, inverse system. Let y of n equals to x of n convolution with h of n be the response of LTI system with input x of n and impulse response of the system h of n. Then the inverse system is nothing but, yeah, that should satisfy this constraint. It's a property of inverse system. When the input is x of n, let me consider h of n is my LTI system impulse response. This is the output I am going to get. I want to design an inverse. Then what should be my output? I want to do reverse for this system, reverse process for this system. Then what should be my output after doing inverse system? That should be same as my actual input, example. Then you can call this as inverse system, impulse response of inverse system, HI of n. It means what I am expecting is this y of n is nothing but x of n convolution with h of n, right? If you apply to LDA system once again, that will be convolved with h y of n. I should expect this convolution should be equal to x of n. Then you can call this as impulse response of LDA system. If you try to apply associative property, convolution with h I of n, that should be equal to x of n. When this is possible, what should be this? It should be delta of n, right? Then x of n convolution with delta of n is nothing but x of n. It should be equal to delta of n. Then you can call this as inverse system to this system. Inverse system to this. Okay, let me consider some example. Why the inverse system to the accumulator system? This is impulse response of accumulator system. Way of n. I want x of n finally. I want this one, 7 to be equals to y of n convolution with h y of n. Let me say this h y of n. Ideally, what I am expecting is this u of n convolution with h y of n should be equals to delta of n. That's what I am expecting. Expecting this one. Can someone answer what will be my h I of n? And by default this side that is 0, minus 1, minus 2 also. See my u of n. Equal to 1 for all n greater than or equal to 0. Equal to 1. Otherwise that is 0, right? Okay, I'll give some statements. Is it true or false? H I of n equals to delta of n minus delta of n minus 1. Is it true or false? I'm claiming that this should be backward difference operation. Yeah, what is the convolution? U of n convolution with delta of n minus delta of n minus 1. Yeah, what is this convolution? Can you speak out?
U of n minus u of n minus 1,
right? It's nothing but delta of n. Nothing but delta of n, right? I'll try to delay this by one sample and I'll subtract. This gets cancelled out. I'll have to with one delta of n. It's an inverse system to the accumulator system and vice versa. Vice versa means if I say what is the inverse system for this backward difference, then you can say accumulator system, right? And we know that this is an FIR system, right? And this is an IAR system. It means inverse system for FIR system can be IAR system. Inverse system for IAR system can be FIR system. Can be. It need not be always true. This can be FIR. For FIR system, inverse system can be IR system. FIR means inverse need not be FIR. IR means inverse need not be IR system. That can be FIR also, right? We'll go to linear constant coefficient difference equations. Linear constant coefficient difference equations is a standard representation. Sigma k equal to 0 to n, ak into y of n minus k equals to sigma m equal to 0 to m, bm into x of n minus m. This is a linear constant coefficient difference equation representation. For example, consider, just for your understanding, let me consider n equal to 2 and m equal to 3. N equal to 2 and m equal to 3, for example. Oh, okay. I'll try to reduce this further. M equal to 1, for example. Implies k equal to 0 to n, right? Ak y of n minus k. A naught y of n plus a1 y of n minus 1 plus a2 y of n minus 2 equals to sigma m equal to 0 to m bm x of n minus m. B naught x of n plus b1 up to m, right? B1 x of n minus 1. Implies my output y of n is nothing but 1 by a naught into b naught x of n plus b1 x of n minus 1 minus a1 y of n minus 1 minus a2 y of n minus 2, right? I am taking this right side. After that, doing division by a naught. Let me consider a naught is not equal to 0. Then only I can do division, right? Division by a naught. Now my output is function of what? This is function of present input, past input, past output. This is also past output, right? My output is function of present input, present out, past input, and past outputs based on this one, right? That can be like this also. It's a recursive. Recursive means this output is function of output. At least you can say output is function of past outputs, right? Along with the inputs, the recursion, output. Difference equation representation of accumulator system. This we have already seen, right? In previous classes itself, sigma k equals minus infinity to n x of k, that can be written like this, which is nothing but x of n plus y of n minus 1. This is the advantage of recursive equation representation. You can go with only two computations, right? Just one computation. We are doing plus x of n plus y of n minus 1. Only one addition we are doing. But here, into do how many additions? Infinite additions you need to do, right? Sigma k equals minus infinity to n minus 1, x of k plus x of n. Infinite additions you need to do. Instead of that, what we can do is, we can try to replace this one with past output, y of n minus 1. Just one addition is enough, instead of having infinite number of additions. We'll try to reduce our computation burden, right? With the help of recursive expressions. Equivalently, y of n minus 1 equals to x of n. It's a block diagram implementation of this accumulator system with the help of recursion. You can try to have it, you can do this. Y of n equals to x of n plus y of n minus 1. This is x of n, right? Getting added to y of n minus 1. This is my output y of n. This is my output y of n. From here, I am applying one sample delay. If you apply one sample delay for this y of n, then I am going to get y of n minus 1. I'll try to add this output with this input. Y of n minus 1 plus x of n minus 1. Then this is nothing but y of n minus 1 plus x of n minus 1, right? This part. In this way, I can try to implement my IAR systems with the help of recursive expressions. I can't implement this straight away. I can't implement this straight away, right? Because I need to go for infinite number of additions. It's not possible for me to implement this directly. I'll try to go with recursive approach. Difference equation representation of moving average system. For example, consider m1 equal to 0. m1 equal to 0 in my moving average system. Then I'm going to get with this expression, which can be rewritten as follows. Okay, do you agree this one? H of n for this one can be written like this. Is it true or false? Can you speak out? Is it true or false? See, H of n can be written like this, right? Replace x with delta. Then H of n equal to 1 by m2 plus 1, sigma k equal to 0 to m2, delta of n minus k. And this part can be rewritten like this. This part, sigma k equal to 0 to m2, delta of n minus k, can be rewritten like this. U of n minus u of n minus m minus 1. If you have doubt, you can have a look into this. What is u of n minus u of n minus 3? Do you agree this? U of n minus u of n minus 3 is nothing but this. U of n minus u of n minus 5 is nothing but k equal to 0 to 4 delta of n minus k. This can be written like this. If you want, you can cross check this one. That's what we are doing here. And I have to replace sigma k equal to 0 to m2 delta of n minus k with this expression. And I know that u of n corresponds to impulse response of accumulator system. And I also know that how to implement this accumulator system with the help of recursive expression. I know this implementation, right? Now I can try to implement this part and this part with the help of this block. It's possible, right? And I can implement this moving average system finally. The one way to implement recursively. This is just a recursive expression. If you want, you can implement this directly also. There is no issue with this one because this is FIR system, right? Then h of n equals to 1 by m2 plus 1. This can be rewritten as follows. Delta of n minus this whole thing, convolution with u of n. These two are equal. This one and this one. These two are equal. And I can try to implement this like cascading of two systems. This is one system. This is second system. This u of n corresponds to accumulator system. Cascading of these two systems, right? If I try to cascade h1 of n and h2 of n, then the effective system will be h1 of n convolution with h2 of n, right? We have seen that this part corresponds to, see, this part is there, right? This part corresponds to this h1 of n. This is the h1 of n. And accumulator system corresponds to u of n. This accumulator system can be replaced by this block. In that way, I can try to implement this system with the help of recursive expression. If you want, you can directly implement this FIR system. That's also fine. I can simply go for some h of n block with sigma k equal to 0 to m2 delta of n minus k. That's also fine. It's one way to implement. It means if you want, you can implement FIR systems also recursively. But if you want to implement IR systems, there is no option for you. You should implement it with the help of recursion only. Thank you. Okay, do we have any doubts?